I designed my own energy drink brand using this amazing new tool. What's going on everyone, my name is Tom from Dreadlabs and today we're going to design a custom energy drink packaging. I've always wanted to get more into packaging design and designing the packaging for a soda or a beer brand is definitely at the top of my list. I unfortunately never had the opportunity to work on a project like this, so today we're doing a self-contained project using a fictional energy drink from my own fictional universe. So basically I have a fantasy universe called the Dreadlabs universe and this is basically my own fantasy world which I use to come up with self-contained projects. If you'd like to learn more about this fictional universe and how I use it, there should be a video popping up on the top right of your screen right now. So the tool that I'm going to use to create this packaging is called Pacdora. Before this project I actually never heard of Pacdora, but they reached out to me to see if I was interested in collaborating together. Now if you're a long term viewer of mine, you know that I don't do sponsored videos that often, and that's because I do them only if I think my audience will actually benefit from it. And Pacdora is one of those websites. So Pacdora is basically a website where you can create 3D mockups for packaging. Whether it's for a soda can like mine, or packaging boxes, pouches, or cups, these can all be made with Pacdora very easily. So after I design our label, we're gonna go into Pacdora and I'm gonna show you a little bit of how I created this mockup. First, we need to pick a can that we're gonna design our label for. What's super useful on Pacdora is that if you click on a design, you can see what resolution the artwork should be if you wanna place it on the mockup. Now without any further ado, let's get into the designing part. So we're designing a tribal structure as the base of our label in Procreate. The drink we're gonna design is called Liquid Chrome, and it contains a mineral found in the Dreadlabs universe called caffeinium. Because of this ingredient, the consumer is able to stay up for a week without the need for sleep. I guess you could say that this drink would make you really, really woke. Anyways, after finishing our design, I dragged my design into Photoshop and I started creating a chrome look for it. Before doing that, I made sure that my tribal shapes were completely solid. If you're confused about what I'm doing here, let me know in the comments and I'll try to explain it step by step. Anyways, after stacking a couple of different layers on top of each other, we got our chrome tribals. I thought it would be cool to place it over a very bright neon color, while also giving it a really obvious drop shadow to add some depth. I sketched the tribals in a way that there's still some space left for a title, a block of text, and some additional elements. I figured I'd place the design that we have so far into Illustrator so I could make some custom shapes and text boxes. First, I had to come up with the title. After that was sorted out, I made a text box that would only fit in between both ends of the tribal on the can. After coming up with some text to put on the can, I quickly found out that the text wouldn't fit nicely since it was pretty large, so I had to play around with it a little bit before I was satisfied with it. To attract potential customers, these drinks usually have a large screaming sticker over the design, and I thought it would be fun to do something like that as well. After some nitpicking, I was ready to drop the design back into Photoshop. But before we do that, I want to ask you a question. Would you be interested in playing around with this Illustrator file or the Photoshop files yourself? Maybe take the tribal shape from the design and do something else with it, like designing a poster? Or copying the layer styles in Photoshop to create something similar with a different title? Well, you actually can. All of the project files from all of my videos are actually available on my Patreon channel. Thanks to my patrons, I'm actually able to release a video every week for free on my YouTube channel. To give you guys this free tutorial every week, I need to work on Dreadlabs during the week. And I cannot do that if I don't generate enough income from Dreadlabs, of course. Otherwise, I'm forced to get another job. Thanks to my Patreon channel, I'm actually able to generate enough income in order for me to create a video every week. I have tons of ideas though, and I would love to get more time to create more videos for you guys. But in order to do that, I need to make enough to pay my rent and focus more on Dreadlabs, if that makes sense. But the fulfilling thought of supporting someone who creates graphic design tutorials on YouTube isn't the only perk that you're getting as a Patreon member. You'll also get access to all of the project files from all of my tutorials, which includes over 100 Photoshop files, over 60 Illustrator files, and even some Cinema 4D and After Effects files. On top of that, you'll get a permanent 15% discount in my asset web store, where I sell texture packs, vector packs, and much, much more. On top of that, you'll also get an exclusive role in the Dreadlabs Discord community server, where we have over 3,000 creators talking about design work, music, asking for feedback, network, share inspiration, and much, much more. There's also another tier, which is slightly more expensive, but this will also get you access to exclusive tutorials, such as a tutorial on how to create your own death metal logos, beginner tutorials to Adobe Illustrator, designing Y2K ray flyers, and more. So if this all sounds like something you've been looking for, there's a link down below in the description if you want to become a Patreon member yourself. Of course, I understand that not everyone has the budget to support Dreadlabs in that way, and that's completely fine. You can become a Patreon member for just 1 month and unsubscribe immediately, and then you'll still have a month of access to all of the files that I talked about. This won't get you access to new files, however, and there are new ones added every month, of course. If you don't have the budget to support Dreadlabs in that way at all, leaving a like and a comment to boost this video in the algorithm is free, as well as subscribing to the channel and sharing this video with your friends. All of these things, of course, really really boost the algorithm. Once again, I want to give a huge shout out to all of my Patreon members, because thanks to you, I'm actually able to share all the tutorials that I'm sharing right now. I wouldn't be able to do this without you. All right, let's head back into Photoshop, where I'm adding some grain to my text. This is also where I should explain the offset filter a little bit. The offset filter can move a layer for you, and if it crosses the edge of your canvas, it lets it enter back in through the opposite side. Just like in Pac-Man. This actually helped me to create a seamless label for my can. Alright, so in Pacdora, I could easily start a new project, drop in the can that I was referencing earlier, and drop my design on there. The reason why I think Pacdora is so valuable for designers is because a lot of graphic designers aren't that familiar with 3D yet. And with Pacdora, there's basically no need to learn about it anyways. If you only want to use mockups, of course. Since Pacdora is also working from your browser, you don't even need to install any software. So I tested out a couple of different scenes, and I found out you can render animations from your products as well, which is really cool. At first, I was a little bit scared since I saw the render options only show you can render in JPEG. But after going back into my editor and making my background transparent, I was able to render a transparent 4K image of my can. So this is the end result you're looking at right now. I'm really happy with the result, and I'm in love with how easy it was to generate these mockups. I'm used to creating these mockups in Cinema 4D, and it can be quite a hassle because you have to get your models yourself, you have to create the materials yourself, and all of that really takes a long time to master. Of course, it gives you a lot more freedom, but usually you don't really need all these settings or need to know about these settings in order to create a proper mockup. I know I am definitely going to use Pacdora to send proposals to my client, and this will maybe one day help me land an actual packaging project. If you are interested in getting Pacdora for yourself, you can explore their website through the link down below, and by using the code Dreadlabs at checkout, you can get a 20% discount on Pacdora Pro. So I want to thank Pacdora for sponsoring this video, and like I said halfway through the video, if you want to get the design files from this video, you can actually become a Patreon member of mine. The link for that is also down below in my description. With all that being said, I want to thank you so much for watching this video. This is Tom from Dreadlabs tuning out, and I'll see you guys in the next video.